We are here not because immigration is a hot topic. Tonight, we are here because we don't really know much about immigrant women's stories and challenges in everyday life.
Felt foreign. The home that I grew up in felt unsafe. The streets that I knew very well felt ominous. And the people that were closest to us felt like strangers. We knew we had to leave. My sister's mother and I came back to the United States and applied to become permanent residents. We knew the journey was going to be extremely difficult. We practically started from nothing, and we lost everything. Being an independent and strong woman, living with three superwomen, I had no other choice but to keep on going. I was blessed to be involved with a WELL organization where I could empower other college university students to be the best that they can be. I also have a blog where I talk about the struggles women face globally and the impacts that they have in our economic, political, and social aspects in life. It's called SheHasEverything.org because she has everything.
After that, I was able to take college classes. So after that, you know, my life changed. I got better jobs, and I just got the one promotion after another promotion. I formed a family. But then I had the opportunity, and I can remember calling my parents and telling them, you won't believe this, I'm in college. I want to get my degree. I had to have a second job to pay for that because I didn't take any loans. I got jobs. I got my bachelor's degree in public safety. I got a one master's degree in public administration from American University, a second master's degree in social work from USC, and today I'm working for the City of Alexandria government as a division chief for administrative services, Department of Community and Human Services. I oversee the operations of programs who help people in need, many of them immigrants, with mental disabilities, with substance abuse, opioid crisis, or the adult and adult or aging services. So I fulfilled my American dream, and it's 2017, September 26, and now I'm running for office to become the first Hispanic female in the Virginia Assembly,